time frames. Madam Speaker, we need to hear today. The Ugandans abroad are watching, their families in the country are watching, and they need to know the fate of their relatives with exact time frames, and the government should give us those today and now.
We got friends from the United States called the Black Star International, who offered to airlift all the Africans that were oppressed in China because of their skin color. I wrote to the Prime Minister of Uganda, and I still insist, Madam Speaker, that the government of Uganda does not need to spend a shilling on that. We have friends that are willing to pay for the return of the people.
I think we should be clear. China is not the world. Honorable Adeke raised the issue of the Ugandans scattered all over the world. And then we instructed the government, please, can you tell us what you are going to do? Or now what you are going to talk about China?
The government of Uganda, through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, is responsible for the protection, the welfare, and the care of all Ugandans who live abroad. No individual can take responsibility for the welfare, the protection of Ugandans abroad. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs, in collaboration with the Ministry of Transport, the Ministry of Health, under the chairmanship of the Prime Minister, is in the process of designing a concrete program in order to ensure that we not only do identify the Ugandans who are living abroad, but identify Ugandans who are stressed and in desperate need abroad, but also an organized manner in which Ugandans can be brought abroad in line with the national order. I seek the indulgence and the patience of everybody in this house, including outside there, in order for us to bring all our Ugandans safely abroad as soon as possible. The government of Uganda's capacity and the will to ensure that we assist all Ugandans abroad and ensure that they come home safely to their families. I thank you.